You mentioned you want parents to be able to make mistakes. Tell me about that. That is, when a parent makes a mistake, how does the parent express that, deal with that with the child? Is it okay to admit to a very little child that you made a mistake?
It is, but I don't want to go there yet. I want to start with that power within the parent. When the children are running the household, what happened was there was that balance shift where the children had too much power and the parents gave over their power. When we're meeting the needs of children, I want those needs out on the table, but I don't want all of us, parents, teachers, adults, fellow eaters in a restaurant, to be held hostage by somebody's incessant demanding needs right here, right now, gotta have it. So what happened, I forgot the question.
The question I asked, what you said I asked, it was too soon, you didn't want to go there yet, so.
Making a mistake. Right. So what happens is, there's that panic in the parent when the mother can't say no to the child with the earring. It's, what if I'm depriving him of some important need? What if I'm making a mistake by saying no? Parenting is taking a chance. It's getting out there and saying, I'm going to be the grown-up. I'm going to be the adult that knows more than the child at all times. You're always smarter than your children, but you don't feel smarter because you don't know the right answer because there isn't a right answer. So in order to make those a day-to-day small parenting decision or the big decisions, parents are become immobilized, and then what happens is they go for the quick fix. How do I just get him quiet now? How do I get through this moment? How do I buy the right thing, have the right thing, do the right thing? And then you get on the entitlement treadmill and you don't have, and then nobody's needs are met.
So are you saying that parents essentially are afraid of their children's unhappiness?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And their own imperfection. And in the book, and I've used it in many places, perfect parents don't raise perfect children. Perfect parents raise children who are not good enough. And so what happens is, we live in the entitlement culture says, buy this, do this, get to the right school. I spoke to someone today, and I've said it for 20 years. I want you to come to mommy and me. I want you to have incredible experiences and opportunities for your child. I want you to be embraced by a community of support. And the same thing with our early childhood programs and our